In the past year, we've seen some very fast monitors, with many brands now offering a 240Hz option, and even some 280Hz variants as well. But now, the Dell Alienware AW2521H is one of the first few monitors to up their game with a 360Hz refresh rate. Hey, I'm Kelsey, a tester at ratings.com, where we help people find the best products for their needs. Make sure you subscribe to our channel for the latest videos or check out our website for the full review. The Dell Alienware AW2521H is one of the first few 360Hz monitors out now and is part of a new wave of 360Hz gaming monitors developed with NVIDIA. These monitors are geared towards esports professionals who need the absolute best in terms of latency and responsiveness. And as we'll see, this monitor is an overall great pick for anyone looking to be on the bleeding edge of gaming. First, we'll look at the design and inputs of the monitor. Then we'll examine various aspects of the picture quality. Afterwards, we'll see just how good it is at gaming with response time and input lag results. And lastly, we'll finish by comparing it to other monitors in its class to see just how it stacks up. If you'd like to skip straight to our test results, then see the links in the description below, or use the YouTube chapters feature. The design of the monitor is very similar to other Alienware monitors and looks exactly like the AW2521HF. It has a black body with thin bezels on three sides, thicker bottom bezel, and a V-shaped stand. It has a gamer-oriented design and RGB lighting on the back of the stand, as well as the Alienware logo and power button. It has an easy-to-remove backplate that hides cables and routes them through the stand for clean cable management. Despite being made of plastic, the build quality is excellent. It feels sturdy all around with minimal wobble from the stand. Overall, it's a well-built monitor. The ergonomics are also pretty great. It has good height adjustment, decent tilt and swivel range, and you can even rotate the display in either direction. Do note though, the stand is quite deep, so it requires a fair amount of desk space. Fortunately, the back of the display features a quick release button, revealing a 100 by 100 VESA mount for those looking to mount the display and save desk space. As for inputs, it comes with two HDMI 2.0 ports, one DisplayPort 1.4, four USB 3.0 ports, a headphone jack, and an audio lineout. Keep in mind, the HDMI 2.0 port will only allow you to do up to 240Hz with an 8-bit RGB signal. So we recommend sticking to DisplayPort if you want to get the most out of this monitor. The on-screen display is controlled by a joystick on the back right of the monitor, along with four buttons to assist with navigation. Now we'll move on to the picture quality, starting with the contrast ratio. Contrast is the ratio between the darkest black and brightest white of the display. The higher the contrast ratio, the deeper the blacks will look with a less washed out looking image. This monitor has an okay contrast and is better than most IPS panels. However, blacks still appear closer to gray when viewed in dark. In brighter environments, however, this won't be much of an issue. Speaking of brighter environments, this monitor performs well in them thanks to its high peak brightness. In our SDR real scene test, we measured around 440 nits and over 430 nits in all our window size tests. For HDR peak brightness, things don't really change much here, as our testing only measured an improvement of 10 to 30 nits. So either way, the monitor's brightness does a good job at overcoming glare in a bright environment. Its HDR performance is decent at best. It will get bright enough to make some highlights stand out in HDR games, but it may not be enough for a satisfying HDR movie experience. Also important for a bright environment is the reflection handling of the display, which is how well it counteracts distracting glare from bright light sources. The Alienware does a good job in this regard, thanks to its matte coating that reduces the intensity of the reflected lights and scatters them, making the reflection less distracting. Overall, you shouldn't have any issue using this monitor in a bright room. If you're in a darker environment, then it's important to have good black uniformity, which is the evenness of an all-black image. Black uniformity issues are presented as brighter areas around dark scenes, which is commonly known as backlight bleed, and can be quite distracting sometimes. Unfortunately, our unit has poor black uniformity, as there is severe backlight bleed in the corners and clouding throughout. It's important to note that black uniformity can vary between units due to manufacturing tolerances, so yours might perform differently than ours. Let us know in the comments if you own this monitor and how it compares. Now let's check out the viewing angles, which is how accurate the image remains when viewed off-centered. Since this is an IPS panel, it has good viewing angles as expected. After all, viewing angles are one of the main benefits of an IPS panel, so you won't get that weird color shifting when looking at the monitor from the side like you do with TN and VA panels. This monitor is a good choice if you need to share your screen with others or if you require the image to remain accurate for professional color work. Now let's take a look at the color accuracy, and this monitor excels in this regard. Out of the box, it offers outstanding accuracy. There are hardly any inaccuracies with the white balance and most colors. Gamma follows the target curve well. The color temperature is on the cold side, giving the image a bluish tint. Keep in mind, this is another aspect of the picture quality that can change due to manufacturing tolerances. But because of the strict quality control of native G-Sync panels, we expect anyone buying this monitor to be pleased with its accuracy. If you want to work in other color spaces or enjoy HDR content, then it's also important to have a wide color gamut. The color gamut is the range of colors a monitor can display, and having a wider gamut means it can produce richer and more vibrant hues that are often used in HDR content. This monitor has an excellent SDR color gamut and perfect coverage of the sRGB color space used in most content. It also has decent coverage of the Adobe RGB color space used in photo editing. Unfortunately, the HDR color gamut is just okay, but it's not considered a wide color gamut for HDR content. It has good coverage for commonly used P3 color space, but limited coverage of the wider Rec 2020. Now the main attraction, the refresh rate. Refresh rate is the biggest factor when it comes to the gaming experience of a display, because a higher refresh rate reduces motion blur and decreases latency, aka input lag. This results in a more fluid, responsive, and lifelike experience that's hard to convey without experiencing yourself. Unlike a traditional 60Hz display, this monitor has a refresh rate of 360Hz, which results in exceptional motion clarity and responsiveness. It also supports G-Sync throughout the entire range, so you'll have nearly tear-free experience as well. Just like the ASUS ROG Swift PG259QN, this monitor is running at an outstanding 360Hz. Its resolution is limited to 1080p, which is fine for most gamers, but it's somewhat limited when it comes to screen real estate and text clarity. So keep that in mind if you plan on using it for lots of multitasking. Now let's look at the response time, which is the time it takes for a display to change from one color to the next. A fast response time reduces the amount of motion blur, which is quite important for gaming. And luckily, this monitor has great response time, so this won't be an issue. At 360Hz, we measured a rise fall time of 3 milliseconds and a total response time of 6.6 milliseconds. We recommended using the fast overdrive setting, which resulted in no overshoot in our testing. At 60Hz, the response time is slightly slower, but still performs incredibly well for 60Hz gaming. This monitor has great motion clarity, but if you want to, you can further improve it by enabling black frame insertion. BFI reduces persistence blur by turning off the backlight between frames. You can learn more about how this works here. This reduction in motion blur clears up the image a lot and makes it easier to track opponents. However, on this monitor, you can only use BFI at either 144 or 240Hz with VRR disabled. It's important to note that our scoring for BFI is fairly primitive and only looks at the supported range. It doesn't factor in the effectiveness of the implementation. This is an aspect we hope to improve in the future. Last but not least, let's check out the input lag. And this shouldn't be a surprise. It's absolutely outstanding. At 360Hz, we measured an input lag of 1.7 milliseconds, which is virtually unnoticeable. This remains low with VRR enabled, but does increase to around 9 milliseconds at 60Hz. However, this is still not perceptible to most people and is fast enough for console gaming. Additionally, this monitor comes equipped with NVIDIA's new Reflex Latency Analyzer. This is a neat tool that measures the real-time latency of your gaming system. To access this, simply plug your mouse into the designated Reflex Latency Analyzer USB port on the monitor. It will then measure the time you click a mouse button to the time it takes for the input to display on the screen and providing you with a full system latency measurement, such as mouse, PC, display, and system latency. You can use any mouse to access this tool except for Bluetooth mouse. However, with an NVIDIA Reflex compatible mouse, you will also be able to measure the peripheral latency. This is a cool feature, especially for competitive gamers, so they can easily measure system latency. So overall, the AW2521H is an excellent gaming monitor, especially for esports professionals and gaming enthusiasts. It has no major flaws and is one of the best displays you can get for gaming, thanks to its incredible refresh rate and low response time. It's an easy recommendation if you can afford its high price. If you're in the market for a 360Hz monitor, then also check out the ASUS ROG Swift PG259QN. You can see our review right here. It's similar to the Alienware, with the main differences being that it's slightly less bright and it has slightly slower response times, and it doesn't have the NVIDIA Reflex Latency Analyzer built in. For that, you would need to get the R variant of the ASUS. They're both good picks, so between the two, it's going to come down to personal preference. So that's it. What do you think of the Dell Alienware AW2521H? Have you bought it? And more importantly, has it made you a better gamer? Let us know in the comments below. As always, you can check out all of the measurements on our website. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel or become an insider on the website for access to our latest results first. Also, we are currently hiring in our offices in Montreal for various positions. So if you want to help people find the best product for their needs, have a look at our career page. Thanks for watching and see you next time.